Hello again, everybody. Welcome back. All right. Last time I attempted this Pathfinder game, on the very first scenario, I failed, and my barbarian there died. So I thought I'd go ahead and give it another go. I wanted to play her again, but since she died, I thought, well, let's go ahead and take another character. But this time I'm going to play as two characters, just to see if I can have a little bit better luck. Solo didn't really pan out too well. So this time around, I'm going to be playing the Dwarf Ranger, Harsk, and I'm going to be playing Sione, the Human Sorcerer. And I've already set the board up. Got the basically the same locations, the woods. I think this might be the new one, the wooden bridge. I can't remember. I gotta look and see. Scenario. Yeah, the wooden bridge is the new location for this area. So we've got that set up. We got the farmhouse again, and we got the waterfront. I already set up the locations, 10 cards in each. Villain is in one of these, henchmen are in the rest. And we got, let's see, this, look at Harsk here. So he's primarily a constitution character and dexterity. But he has some nice little ranged stats and a couple other wisdoms and all that. But I went over and went Sione also, because I needed a little bit of help with charisma and all that. She's not that good melee fighter, but hopefully her spells will pan out. And I need to shuffle everybody's decks here. These are not custom decks. I just went ahead and using the starter decks from the back of the manual, because I didn't want to take the time to sort all that stuff out. So I'm just going with default decks. Hopefully they'll pan out. And let's look at Harsk's abilities here. He's proficient in light armor, has a hand size of 5. He's proficient in weapons as well. And at the end of his turn, at any time, I can examine the top or bottom deck of bottom card of the location deck, but I can't do the bottom card yet until I level up. But still, at the end of each turn, he can look at the top of whatever location deck he's at. So it's nice. That's a nice little scouting ability. And he may also recharge a card to add a 1d4 to a combat check at any other location. Which is basically what the crossbows and all that stuff do. And let's look at Sione. Hand size of 6, proficient in nothing. And see if her combat check, I may discard a card or roll the arcane die plus 1d6 with magic, attack, and fire traits. It counts as playing a spell. I never played a sorcerer, so this is going to be new for me. But let's see, her arcane is a d12 plus 2, so it's not bad at all. So d12 plus 2 plus whatever her spell is. And automatically you see their check at recharging spells with arcane traits, and later on it'd be with items, so that'd be nice as well. So anytime she uses an arcane spell, it automatically goes back into her draw pile there. Okay, so like I said, I got everything set up. Here's the one villain with henchmen's, and during the scenario, monster's power causes you to recharge one or more cards. Do so, then draw the same number of cards. If monster's power causes you to recharge one or more, do so, then draw the same number. Okay. And reward for this one, each character draws a random item from the box. Alright, so I need to figure out where we're going to go. Let's see, Harsk. Let's look at each location here. Undefeated monsters, other than villains or henchmen, are banished. Succeed at a wisdom or survival check. His survival, he has some, I think. Yeah, he's got survival. So wisdom or survival, he has both. Wisdom, d6, survival, plus 2, so he has a decent chance of closing that one down. Sione is just a d6, so right now Harsh is looking good to go there. Plus he's more combat focused, possibly. I don't... yeah. She has one combat spell, I know. Can't remember if the other two were offhand. Alright, let's see the wooden bridge. Discard 2 cards to evade an encounter. Succeed a dexterity or stealth check. Let's see, dex is going to be mainly on Harsk as well. D8, but you don't have any stealth. No, she's the only D8 as well. So both of them have a chance to close that one down, but neither have stealth. Alright, farmhouse. Discard an ally. Bury it instead. Somebody feed a random monster, and there's 3 monsters there, so nothing really special there. Waterfront. Playing weapons subtract 1 from each die rolled. After exploration, you may discard 2 cards, explore again, summon and defeat abandoned henchmen to close it. All characters on location discard a card when it's closed. Alright, so let's see what we got in here. This one has 1 item, 2 allies. Not much there. Farmhouse. 1 weapon, 3 items, and an ally. Wooden bridge. 1 armor, 3 allies, and a blessing. And the woods. Just 1 weapon and 2 items. There's really not much around here. Neither one of these gives spells, so Sione's going to be stuck with what she has for now. So let's see, who's going to go where? We'll go ahead and just throw Harsk over here in the woods, why not? Throw him there. And Sione, There's three monsters here, there's one barrier. Three allies, though. She might need some more allies, I'm not sure. Let's have a look here. Let's see, look at their hands. Alright, let's see. They can have five weapons in his hand, well, in his deck, one armor, no spells, three items, one ally, five blessings. That's all they can have right now. So you can never have spells until he levels up. Sione, on the other hand, can never have weapons till she levels up, can never have armor at all. So, yeah. Okay, well, let's go ahead and draw their starting hand. Is it what? Is your starting hand? Hand size 6. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I need to sort this stuff out. Alright, let's go ahead and flip these over. Alright, so she's got an ally, one spell, one blessing, item, and another ally. Okay, might have to make some more room here. Okay, Harsk's hand size is 5, proficient in, well, favorite as a weapon, so he has to have at least one weapon. She had to have at least one spell, she got that. Okay, so one, whoops, not the whole deck here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Flip these over. Alright, he's got one weapon to start with, 2 weapons. Blessing, 3 weapons, and 2 blessings. Alright, so not bad, he's got 3 of his 4 starting weapons. So we get to go for combat-wise. Okay, so she has one piece of armor. Well, it's actually an item, but it decreases damage, so that's her best if she can get armor-wise. Except for her spell. I think she has an armor spell as well. But anyway, let's see. She wants to go where? Succeed, dexterity, or stealth. Summon to defeat a random monster. Now let's go ahead and send her over here. She has another blessing in there. She can have 5, so maybe she'll get a replacement in there. So we'll send her over here. And I guess I'll go ahead and start with Harsk. So, blessing number 1. Blessing of Desna. Discard this card, add 2 dice to recharge a card. That's not really that great. Alright, so let's start. Card number 1. Rat Swarm. Combat of 8. If you do not defeat the Rat Swarm by at least 4, shuffle it to the deck it came from. So that's not that big a deal. Alright, so combat 8. Alright, so he's got his light crossbow. That's his heaviest weapon he has right now. So that's a d8 plus his dex, which is also a d8. So he's rerolling. Get back up there. 2d8 plus he's ranged, since he's using the ranged item here. So 2d8 plus 3 is what he's going to be rolling. Alright, so the 8 is right here. So he already has a 3. 4, 5. Yeah, he killed it. Alright, so the Rat Swarm is gone. Add that back to the monster stack. And so go ahead and use a blessing. Add that to his discard stack over here. Now add it on top so I'll know where it is. I don't want to mix up with the rest of the stuff. But use a blessing to go again. Not the whole deck. Collapse ceiling. Alright, difficulty to defeat the barrier is increased by the adventure deck. I think I was doing that wrong last time. I kept adding a +1 if I remember correctly. This is not even an official scenario for the adventure. This is just the base set, so it doesn't count as a number. So it's 0, so it has to roll an 8. If I fail to check defeat by 4 or more, and deal 1 combat damage. Eh, it's not that big a deal. It's got to be a 4. And let's see, Dexterity, Acrobatics, Constitution, and Fortitude, 8s. So he'll be reading a d8 again. He has to beat an 8. He doesn't have any Acrobatics. Constitution, well, he does have a Constitution. There we go. So a d12 for his Constitution. So he has to beat an 8. Before he does that, I guess he'll go ahead and spend a blessing so he can roll this twice to have a good chance at it. Alright, so it's a 3, he needs at least a 5. Well, he does need a 5. 5 or better. And we got a 6. Okay, so he passed that. So nothing takes place. Alright, so that's gone. And he can't go again, because he doesn't have anything to go. So drop back up to his hand size. There's his other crossbow. And he's got a crowbar. Alright, that's his turn. Now it's her turn. Let's see. Discard a card to add 2 die to combat strength. That's not going to do her any good right now either. At least not yet. And discard 6. Alright, nothing here. Card number 1. Goblin Commando. Before the encounter, Goblin deals 1 range damage. Well, that sucks. 1 range damage. So let's go ahead and use the bracers to reduce combat damage by 1. So that's discarded. So she took no damage, but actually she did. But anyway, now I gotta do a combat of 9. She won't have a combat spell, though. All she can do is a d4. So she doesn't have anything to actually attack here. Well, I can discard to evade. And it's arcane, so it automatically go back into her hand. Yep, automatically see to check to recharge a spell. So this is an arcane check, so it automatically go back in her hand, and it automatically evades. But it would get shuffled back into the deck there, so she won't beat it. So that's not going to do her any good. So she'll go ahead and do that. So she gets her attack spell. She evaded it, shuffled it back in. She'll use a blessing. It's her allies again. Dexterity and charisma check. That's on combat, that's perception check. So that's not going to do any good. She used a blessing to go again. Now she got a dog ally. Let's see. Recharge this card at 1d10 to her perception. What's this one over here? The guard is at 1d6 perception. So yeah. It's a better perception check. This one lets you explore again. You banish this one, it takes 3 less damage. But anyway, let's see if we can get it to wisdom or survival 5. Wisdom's a 6, she doesn't have survival. So it's a pretty good chance she's not going to get this, but I need to roll again. 5. Yeah, 5 or 6, and she gets it. And she rolled a 5. She got her dog. Alright. And she'll go ahead and use it right off the bat to explore again. Okay, chainmail. Constitution 42-3. She can't have armor, but she can use it for the rest of the scenario. So, yeah, Constitution 42-3. Constitution is a 6. No fortitude. So 3 or higher, she'll have some armor. That would help her out. And she got a 3, so she has a piece of armor. That'll help her out a lot, too. And that's all she can do, unless she wants to use one of the other guys. Discard the troubadour. Explore again. Like she'll do that. Discard that. Go one more time. Locked passage. If defeated, examine the top card of the location deck, then put it on either the top or the bottom. Okay, let's see, dexterity or disable 8, or strength melee 16. Well, she has no chance at all of doing the dexterity, I mean the strength, but a d8 dexterity, she has a 1 in 8 chance of getting it. Alright, so let's go ahead. 8, there it is. And if defeated, examine the top card. Doesn't say if it stays, though, if she loses. I'm assuming it just goes away. If defeated. It doesn't say either way. I'm just going to guess that you only have 1 chance at it. But I'm not sure. Just it doesn't specify there. Doesn't have an undefeated text there. Well, she rolled a 7. She didn't do it. So let's go ahead. I'm assuming it stays, though. Defeat, examine the top card of the location deck, then put it on. It doesn't say. It's a lock, so I'm assuming it stays here. Yeah, but let's go ahead and leave it there. I think that's how that plays out. Otherwise, why would you put it at the top or the bottom? No, never mind. It's for the other card. Yeah. So, yeah, I think that goes. Like I said, it didn't have an undefeated thing, so I'm assuming it only has the 1 thing. Alright, so she can't go again. So let her draw back up to her hand size. 6-1. There's another ally. That's her survival check. Yep, that's her survival check. That'll come in handy. 4. There's her armor spell. 5. Another blessing. And 6. Fortitude item. That'll help for a fortitude check. Okay, and her turn is done. She's down to 5 cards. She doesn't have any healing. Wait a minute. Did I put that card in here? No. That goes back into the deck. There we go. Arcane spells automatically go back into her draw pile. Alright, so she's down to about half life now already. Just off of that. Not good. She can't really heal herself, so I need to take it easy here. Alright, blessing of the gods. Back to Harsk. And heal explore. Ambush. Difficulty to hit the barriers increased by an adventure deck number. We don't have to worry about that. If defeated, it may immediately explore again. Okay, so wisdom, perception, dexterity, or acrobatics. Check of 9. Dexterity of 8. What type of trap is that? It's just an ambush. Yeah. So we can't really defeat this. Wisdom, perception, dexterity, and acrobatics. Wisdom, d6. Well, it's a d6 plus 2, so it's an 8. His dexterity is an 8. He has no acrobatics. He has no perception. Yeah, he does. He has an 8 perception. See, only best he can do is an 8. And you have to get a 9, so he has no chance of defeating this. Alright, if undefeated, examine the location deck until they find the monster, encounter it. Subtracting 1 from each die rolled to your deck. Check. Banish this card and shuffle the remaining cards. So she could use a blessing to help him out for this, if she really wanted to. But again, she only has 6 cards in here. And only 3 of them she can constantly recycle. So yeah, she needs to take it easy here. We got plenty of turns left, so I don't want to keep pressing her for cards. So I'll just go ahead and fail that. Examine the location deck until I find a monster. Okay. So that's one way of scouting what we got in here, though. Well, that's a monster. Well, this counts as a henchman, but I'm assuming it counts as a monster as well, since it's not officially. But that's the first thing that came up. It's a henchman. It's not really a monster. So I don't know if that would actually count. It says monster, so I'm going to go with monster. And there's a monster there. Okay. So we know there's a bandit in here, not the villain. Let's get shuffled back. And now we got a siren. Okay. The siren is the wisdom 8 check. That's the best he can do is an 8, but he has a crossbow and all. But it's not going to help him, really. Well, it might, just a little bit. All damage done by the siren is mental damage that may not be reduced. If undefeated, examine the top 3 of your deck and discard any allies. Okay. So it's a wisdom 8. She doesn't have any wisdom things there, so it's a d8 plus whatever I got here for combat check reveal. This. But it's not a combat check, though. It has to defeat a wisdom check. The best he can do is a 6 on wisdom. Reveal this card whether dexterity or ranged. So I'm missing 1d. You know, how does this even work? Now, I'm assuming he could use this. It'd have to be your wisdom, but. How does that even work, though? I mean, it's a range. Wisdom. He can't defeat wisdom, so I'm assuming he can't defeat this. Again, if I'm making any rules mistakes here, let me know in the comments and everything. But I'm going here to check the defeat is a wisdom. He only has a wisdom of 6, so he can't defeat it. So yeah, I'm going to assume he can't defeat this. So I have to roll a d6 and see how much damage he takes. At least that's how I'm reading it, anyway. So you have to beat a wisdom check, and since it doesn't say combat, and these weapons are combat checks. And these are all combat checks. Again, yeah. I'm just going to go with that. So if it's wrong, let me know. But I'm going to go with, since he has nothing here that does wisdom damage or anything, since this is a magical creature. And I'm just going to go with the d6 that he rolls by default. And just take what damage you can off of that. So roll a 6, that's good. He only took 2 damage. So I'll go ahead and discard the crowbar and discard the sling. So it took 2 damage. Examine the top 3 cards of your deck and discard any allies. Hopefully there's no allies. 1, 2, no allies. Alright. So put them back in here. Shuffle them back up. He only has 1 ally anyway, if I remember correctly. Alright, this gets banished. And she gets put back in there. No, take that back. Crap. Well, I just kind of screwed that up. Well, I kind of know what's in there anyway. I gotta find that siren. I've got the location thing here. Undefeated monsters are automatically banished. So she's gone. Again, shuffle this back up. I didn't pay attention really well to what was in there. But anyway, getting a few rules wrong. Possibly. I know I am. Probably am. But anyway, like I said, I haven't played a whole lot of this, so I'm still trying to learn. And some of the wording on some of these is kind of screwy. But anyway, let's do it for him, because he don't have any more ways to go again. But he's going to, end of his turn, he's going to scout. He's got a sneak to come up with next. It's combat 9, so he should have no problem defeating that. Draw back up to his hand size. So there's, no, there's my ally. And 1 item. Hand size is 5, right? Yeah, hand size is 5. Okay, his round's done. And we're back to Sione. Okay, so go ahead and draw. Archer ally. Recharges card at 1d4 to ranged. She has no ranged, really. Dexterity arranged as charisma or diplomacy. She has diplomacy, so d12 plus 2. She has a pretty good chance of getting this. She just has to beat a 6. D12 plus 2, just need a 6 or higher. And she got a 1, so yeah. Archer says, screw you, I don't work for wizards. And there's the ally deck down here. Alright, so there's that. And he has a blessing, so should go ahead and use it. Go again. And another ally. Wisdom Perception 7, Charisma Diplomacy 6, so basically the same thing. Recharge his card to add 1d10, discard to explore again. Alright, so it's got a 6 or higher again. And it's a 2, she failed yet again. Pretty horribly. Allies don't seem to care about her at all. Alright, there's 5 cards left here, so she can't go again unless she discards somebody. But she needs to save some cards for damage purposes, just in case. So she got another blessing, and that'll do it for her turn. Okay, back to Harsk. Okay, Explorer. We know there's a sneak coming, so here we go. Difficulties increased by the adventure, don't have to worry about it. Before the encounter, succeed a Wisdom or Perception 8 check, or discard 1 card. So Wisdom Perception, he has a bonus to both of those. So 6 plus 2 is an 8, he has to get an 8. So it looks like he's going to be discarding something here. He has to roll an 8 or he discards. Got a 3, so he's going to have to discard something. Sharp bows of 1d6. Whoop. God dang it. Go ahead and discard the short bow. Still has 2 crossbows left. Now we'll do the combat. That's a 9, so 1d8 plus 1d8 plus 3. So 3. There's 8 right there. He can't lose. So he has 1 more roll and only needed 1. So sneak is defeated. And could use the crow to go again. He's got 6 cards left in his hand. But you know what? I think we'll just wait. Still got 25 turns left. There's no point in pushing the issue. So let's draw another card. There's his blessing again. And let's see Yoni go ahead and go. Blessing of the Gods. So that's good. She can use a blessing and it automatically recharge. Okay, so here we go. And there's the villain. Alright, before we even do that, I'm going to try to shut this location down. Succeed at a wisdom or survival 6. Wisdom 6 plus 2. So she has an 8. Need a 6 or higher to temporarily close that location down. And it's a 4, so it's not closed. Wait a minute, it's a 4. I said, what was it? Wisdom survival 6, yeah, rolled a 4 plus 2 survival. So yeah, this one's temporarily closed for now. Well, I know it's temporarily closed. Alright, so we can't run there. You can go to these other two locations, though. Okay, before the encounter, recharge 2 cards of your choice from your hand. Let's go ahead and recharge that one and the guide. No, this one's gone. I'll make it close if she wins. So, go ahead and recharge these two. Alright, so a combat of 10. Which is going to be tough for her because she has no weapons still. She doesn't have her offensive spell. Gar's not going to help her. There's nothing she can really do. Discard this reduced combat damage dealt to you by 2. Maybe play this card even if you have played another spell. So she cannot possibly defeat this. It's a combat of 10. Well, she technically can if she uses her blessing. She's basically using a 2d4. No, she can't do it. 2d4 times 2 is all she can do. Because she has no offensive capability right now. So yeah, she's going to lose this. Oh, I need a 4. That's her only damage she can do is a 4. And she's going to recharge this blessing so she can't roll that die twice. Like I said, that blessing's recharged because it's the same blessing that's in play right now for the turn counter. I was doing that stuff wrong last game too. So she'll roll this twice. She can't possibly defeat the guy. So there's a 4. And she did 7, so she takes 3 damage. She can recharge this to reduce it by 2. Or she can just, she could banish this guy to reduce it all the way so she takes no more damage. So yeah, I think she'll go ahead and do that. Oh crap, what is this? There's her offensive spell right there. Apparently it got drawn by accident. That would have helped her. No wonder we wouldn't get it. Didn't even know I drew that card. Anyway, well, that could have changed some things around. But she's going to go ahead and banish the guard. So she's not going to take any more damage. Only supposed to take 3 damage. The guard's going to take all 3 for him. So, no damage she's taking. But now, we've got to get 2 more blessings. He's going to run away to one of these 2 locations here. No, wait a minute. That one's temporarily closed. I got to draw. No, yeah, this one's still open. He didn't beat her. Going to run away to any of these. So he could still be in the same place. Or he could be in one of these other 2. This isn't going very well for us right now. Alright, so that's all she can do. So let's go ahead and draw back to her hand size. There's her force missile she was been looking for. Yeah, that would have helped. Arcane plus 2d4. Hurricane's a d12 plus 2 plus 2d4, so yeah, she would have put a hurting on him, possibly. Blast Stone, that would have helped her too. Another 1d4 to her combat. There's a guy, one more card, and a blessing. Alright, so her turn's done. Blessing of Shaylin. Non-combat wisdom, so don't really need that. Alright, back to Harsk. Now we got a Satyr. All damage dealt by the satyr is mental that may not be reduced. Okay, it's a dexterity acrobatic 9. But he does dexterity damage, so He's got a pretty good chance of doing this. Again, 2d8 plus 3. We're going to beat a 9, right? 9, so we're at a 4. Ugh. 5, you kidding me? Well, it's going to take 4 damage. I'm going to discard that and reduce it by 1. And go ahead and get rid of the crow as well. That sucked. So the satyr gets banished anyway for being undefeated at this location. And he'll go ahead and go and use the blessing. No, he won't. He'll go ahead and hang on to that. He's down to 5 cards. Like I said, I don't want to keep pushing the issue. So, not going well at the moment, that's for sure. There's his armor he could have used. That would have been nice to have in his hand. I'll reduce it by 1 damage, but still, it recharges. Alright, so he's done. Moving on to her. Still got 22 turns left, we're good. Alright, now she's ready for a fight. And here's this guy again. 1 range damage. Go ahead and recharge the chainmail so she doesn't take any. Okay, combat 9. So she's going to use her force missile, which is an arcane, plus 2d4 with a force. So arcane, d12 plus 2 arcane. So this should kill him. There's an 8. Needed a 9. He's already got it. So he's dead. And I think that'll do it. Like I said, we still got plenty of turns left. They're both pretty much a half life. So yeah, just don't want to keep pushing the issue. Since they still have no way of healing themselves right now, really. Draw back up, and the blessing. It's blessing of the gods, good. So he can use these as all he wants, and then it does recharge. That stack's getting pretty wobbly. Hopefully I don't tip over. Alright, so, again, let's go back. Potion of Hiding. Intelligence craft of 4. Challenge is a 6, no crafting, so he's got a slight chance to get it. And it's a 4, he got it. And that adds what? Banish to choose character, location to succeed, stealth check. Alright, he'll use a blessing and recharge it, since it's just the current timer blessing going on right now. Go again, and there's the henchman, okay. For the encounter, recharge a card of your choice. Go ahead and recharge the potion. You don't need it. Okay, combat 8. So it'll be a d8 plus d8 plus 3. Hopefully I have better luck this time around. So 3, we're at a 7. You got one more roll, you cannot lose. So the henchman is dead. Now I may attempt to close and have to succeed at a wisdom or survival 6 check. Which should be a 6 plus 2. Alright, need a 4 at least. 4 better. And we didn't close it. God dang it. Well, that location is still open. But luckily there's only 2 cards left to deal with. So deck is wobbling way too much. Alright, I need to fix this deck real quick. It's going to wobble that bad. I'm going to tell him what it's going to do when it gets big enough here. Alright. Alright, so he's done. Okay, so draw it back. Another blessing. Nice. He's back to his hand size. Okay, it's her turn. Let us Stop that. I'll put it to the side so I know it's hers. Right, she'll go again. And she got a free blessing. Nice. And she'll go ahead and... Yeah, has to discard it. Otherwise she'll refresh it. But she'll go again with that. And she found another one. And she'll go ahead and discard that and go again. And we got a skeleton. Skeleton is immune to mental and poison traits. It's a combat 8. Technically, she could beat this if she uses this. Give her a 1d4. But she has to use a blessing as well, pretty much, to have any decent shot at it. You know what? She'll do that with the blessing. She'll use the blast stone. She'll banish that. So it's 1d4 plus the d4. So she has 3d4 going against this skeleton. Since she doesn't have her missile, which I forgot to recycle back into her deck. So it's going to be a little while before she gets it back anyway. Since she only has that one. So yeah, we'll banish the blast stone. So she has 3d4 going at it. This guy. It's the best she can do. 3d4 to get an 8. There's a 3. 4, not good. That's the roll of 4 here. And she got a 1. So she's taking 3 damage right now. But she can discard this, but it's arcane, so she'll automatically get it back to reduce damage by 2. And she'll have to lose her guide as well. So she'll recharge that. And she'll lose her guide. And it's all she can do. And he'll get shuffled back in. That sucks. Again, we're not having any luck at all right now. There's an invisibility spell, another blessing. Fortitude. There's the guide again. She needs that missile. She's not getting it. She's only down to 2 cards left. She's really got to be careful here. She's close to dying. Again, we have no way of healing ourselves. Unless we find more items. That's the only way we can do it here. Alright, so Blessing of Callistra. Discard this stat 2 to a non-combat dex check. Alright, so his go. Potion of Healing. That will come in very handy. Intelligence of a 5. His intelligence is a 6. Plus 1. It's technical to get it, but I think he's going to use a blessing. So he can roll 2d6s to try to get this thing. 2d6. What was it again? Intelligence. Craft. Yeah, it's just intelligence. So 2d6s to get a 5 or higher. It's a 5. He can't fail. So he's got a potion of healing. And she definitely needs that. So whenever they get to that location, she can give it over. And she'll heal 1d4 her cards. Because she's in need of it more than he is at the moment. Alright, so got that. Sucks, we have to use the last blessing to go again. Still 19 rounds. We have still got 2 more locations we haven't even explored yet. But we'll go ahead and take the chance. He'll use his last card to peek. It's the Stark Knife. So it's nice little item. He's got 5 cards in his hand, so we'll stick with that. And she'll draw. And she'll go. It's okay, well. She can evade it if it's the skeleton again. And it's not. It's the ghoul. And this is even worse to defeat. So yeah, she will recharge her invisibility. Since that's arcane, if I remember correct. Yeah, it's arcane. So she will recharge that. Since she has no chance of beating this guy right now. She'll recharge it, go invisible, and evade the creature. So we know we got a skeleton. and a ghoul in here. So she's no longer needed here. She can't do anything there. And she will draw one card. There is her force missile. She can kill something now, but her turn's done. Okay. She's no good here. Where does she want to go next? There's three monsters there. There's four monsters there. So yeah, her next best bet, farmhouse. There's items there. And she could get a weapon. That would help her out too. But yeah, her turn's done. So moving on to Harsk again. This is another non-combat strength, but... let's go ahead and explore. Finish this location off. And he's got a knife. Add that to his weapon stack. Now he's going to attempt to close this again. Wisdom or survival. So it's a d6 plus 2. Still has a chance to close it. And he failed, so it's still open. And he's not going to use a blessing to go again. Alright, so her turn. Discard, discard, add 2 to non-combat charisma. Okay, so she's going to move. She's not going to deal with anything there. So, yeah. So her first card she meets here is a shadow, combat 13. Shadow is immune to mental and poison. She's using a force missile, which is neither of those. To check the defeat, does not have magic trait, it is undefeated. Look, she is using magic. She has her force missile. So now this has to be to 13. Sucks it's not a blessing of the gods, so she can get her blessing back. But anyway, she's going to use the force missile. So that's a d12 plus 2d4 plus 2 to beat a 13. So d12 plus 2d4s plus 2. So we're at 2. We're at 6. No, she's going to go ahead and use this blessing too, just to be sure. So it is still kind of tough to defeat. So 2d12s. Now we're at 6. 13. She's already tied it, so it's defeated. So that creature is gone. Does she want to go again, though? She can if she uses her guide. She's got to summon and defeat a random creature to close this. That's the one with dexterity and stealth. So this won't help her there. You know what? She only has 2 cards left, so she's gonna skip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. And she'll recharge that. So she has 1 card left in her hand. So yeah, she's definitely not gonna press her luck anymore. And let's see. Alright, Harsk is going to go ahead and try to close this yet again. So he's going to roll his d6 plus 2. Needs to be a 6. And he got a 6. Alright, this place is closed, finally. And in closing, nothing happens. Alright, so we don't have to worry about that. So that place is closed, and his turn is over. Alright, half the game is over. Alright, Blessing of the Gods, that's what she needs. She can waste that one now. But does she want to take a chance going? She has armor, which reduces it by 2. She can always, and she got her arcane spell for armor, so she's pretty good right now. She can't really do damage, though. She doesn't have her missile. But she can do a 2d4 damage-wise. But she can't evade, so go ahead and go. And it's a night watch. Recharge this for that blah. See wisdom perception 7 or charisma diplomacy 6. She'll go ahead and use her charisma d12 plus 2. And it's a 7. She needed a 6. She got it. So she's got an extra hit point in her hand. And she'll recharge the blessing, since that's the current blessing right now on the timer. To go again. Or will she? No, she's not going to do that. She'll leave that. She'll discard the Night Watch she just got to go again. Masterwork Tools. Dexterity disable 7. Her dex is only an 8. So she's not a real good chance of getting this, but that would come really in handy. But she has a real slim chance of getting it, though. Really nice to have for either one of these characters. 7 or 8. And we got an 8. Even says, though, right there, 8. So she got some tools. Masterwork tools at that. Really nice little item to have. And does she want to go again? She can discard a guide. She still has 6 cards in her hand. Well, she could recharge that blessing. Now she will charge the blessing to go again. And another item. Potion of Glibness. Intelligence 4. Her intelligence is a 6. Not real smart for her. Wizard. Sorceress. And she didn't get it. Oh well. So that's gone. That would have been nice to have. And I think she's going to stop there. So she's down to 6. She's going to go ahead. Nah, she's not going to discard. She only has 2. We know the Force Missile's next and the Blessing's under that. So could discard to get another one. To get her attack spell. I think she will. Because Hearth is going over there to anyway to heal. So she'll discard that. To get her Force Missile back in her hand. So she has all 3 of her spells in her hand right now. And her turn's over there. And we're back to Hearth, who has a blessing. He's going to move over here. He's going to get the potion to her. So she can use that on her turn. And he's going to give her a Stark Knife as well. Or will she? I'll just give him a crossbow. She don't have a range bonus, but she can at least do some range damage. So yeah. Alright, so she can at least attack with a crossbow now. And he'll explore now. I think that's all the items. There's 3 items. There's still 3 monsters, a barrier, 1 weapon, and 1 ally in here. And the henchman. So we might not get anything. Possible the villain's in here, too. Alright, so recharge 1 card. Go ahead and recharge the Stark Knife. Alright, so D8. So he's going to use the crossbow again. So that's 2 D8s plus 3. Is that a 3 already? And 7, he's got 1 more roll. He cannot lose. Henchman is defeated. And now we can attempt to close this. And just gotta summon and defeat a random monster. So we'll go ahead and shuffle the monster deck up. Draw 1. And it's mercenary. Difficulty increased. Not worried about that. And it's a combat 10. So 2d12s. I mean, 2d8s plus 3. He's got a pretty good chance to defeat it. If not, he's got armor. It's a blessing of the gods, so why not? He'll go ahead and recharge his blessing. Just to have an extra roll. Just to be sure. We want this thing closed. Alright, so 3d8s plus 3. Just to beat a 10. So 4. 5. 3 or higher. 7. Alright. Mercenary is defeated. And this location is closed. What was in here? Boots of Elvenkind. Large chest. Eh, not that bad. That's a promo monster. Oof. Good thing I didn't run into it. Blessing of the Gods. Spectre. That one would have sucked. Have to be magic only to kill that thing. And a longsword. A longsword would have been nice to have. Oh well, that's all closed. Alright, weapons. So there's no villain in there. Which Elven Con would have been nice to have as well. Alright, so this one's closed. Nothing happens for closing? No. Well, the villain is in this final deck over here. We know that for sure. Alright, here we draw. Holy water. That could be used to it later. Short bow. And a blessing. Okay. So he's down to 3. Alright, so it's Ione's turn. Let's see. No, she's not going to go over there, even though technically she could kill what's there. But we'll take the chance to go over here. Hopefully we don't draw the villain to start with. It's -1 when playing a weapon, subtract 1. She does have a weapon now. She's got a handful of cards now, too. Before she does anything else, she's going to go ahead and banish this potion of healing to do 1d4 healing. Alright, come on, 4. Alright, so what she rolled was a 4. Alright, so 4 cards back into her hand. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. So she's back to 5 cards in her discard pile. I mean her draw pile. And she's got a bunch of discard here. Alright, now it's explore time. So it's just the negative for her weapons. Alright, it's a specter. So it's a magic only creature. Luckily she has her magic missile. Specter's immune to metal and poison. Don't worry about that. Secret defeat does not have magic. Not worried about it. So this is a wisdom, divine, or a combat 11. She's going to go ahead for a combat. So combat 11. So she's going to do this one. Well, technically she can use the crossbow, but yeah, it has to be magic. So 1d8 plus 2d4. She has no blessings here. Well, I didn't draw a blessing for her yet. Blessing of gods. Not that it would matter. Okay, so needed, whoops, d8s. So 1d8 plus 2d4 to beat an 11. We're in a different location, so could help. He's got 3 cards left. Yeah, he better not. Let's say I can go ahead and discard that to give her another d4, but we're alright. What happens if you do fail? Just move it to a random location, so it can come back here or can go over there. We'll stay with what we got. Alright, so 1d8. No, 1d12. What am I doing? This is magic. 1d12 plus 2 plus 2d4 to be an 11. Did not need a 1 right there. He has no chance of defeating it now. God damn it. So we'll go ahead and recharge. I need anything but low numbers on that 12 roll. God damn. Alright, so I still gotta roll to see how much damage she's gonna take. That's 1, 2, 3 she's at right now. 4, 5, 6. So she took 5 damage off of this. Well, there's 2, 3, 4, and she'll get rid of the guide. So this gets recharged. That gets recharged. This gets recharged. That was a horrible turn. That one right there just killed it. All momentum we just had right there. Let's see. There's the blessing we could have used. And another one. And another one. So she's good to go for weapon combat. So move to a random location. So 1, 2, well, let's see. 1, 2, 3 over here, 4, 5, 6, she's back over there. And he's back in this deck. Of course he is. So he's back in there somewhere. Okay. 11 turns left. And Harsh turn. We need to go over here and close this down. He can fight what's over there. Card number one. There's the skeleton. But he's going to be a plus three since he's using piercing weapons, so he's got to roll an 11 or better. Off of 2d8s, plus three. It's a blessing of the gods, so that's helps. So we'll go ahead and recharge the blessing. Wait a minute. Hold on. Holy water. I'm not supposed to evade. I could banish it to kill him. No, I'm going to be an 11. Never mind. So yeah, let's go ahead and recharge the blessing. To roll 3d8s, plus 3. Dead. Got two more rolls. There's no way I could fail that. So he's gone. But now he can't go again since he used the blessing. So his turn's over. Sucks. Needed that blessing to go again. Oh well, can't be helped. Alright, so we got down to the final 10 turns. It's not the blessing of the gods. This is going to help her. So she's got 3 she could use this turn and recharge them all. Alright, card number 1, Pit Trap. Wisdom Perception 7, Dexterity or Acrobatic 8. She has no perceptions. That's a 6. And some 8, so. But again, she can recharge this. Hold on. Recharge this card. Defeat a barrier whose highest difficulty defeat is 14 or lower. She can defeat that right now. Yep. That barrier is gone, thanks to those tools she picked up. Told you that thing was nice to have. So she won't have to worry about using a blessing. She'll use one now and recharge it. To go again. Snake. Recharge this card to add 1d10 to your stealth. Eh, she don't really need that. Discard this to add 1d4 to melee. That'll be help her out a little bit. See, Wisdom Survival 6. She has to roll a 6. She's not going to waste a blessing to try to get him. Almost got it. One more rollover. So no snake for her. She'll recharge another blessing to go again. She has 7 cards left. Alright, she's good. Large chest. Difficulty to defeat the barrier is increased by the adventure deck. Not worried about it. If defeated, add 1d4 random weapons. So Dex 9, she can't do that. So Strength Melee 10, she can't do that either. She has no chance at all of beating this unless I use the Blessing to go again. So Dex 8, so I can roll 2d8s. Might as well recharge it. To beat a what? To beat a 9. There's a 1. That's not going to do us any good. Gotta roll a 7 or an 8 now. Nope. And it's gone. I may banish it or I can leave it here. 10 turns. I need to get this going. Running out of time. So we'll go ahead and banish it. And she is done. She can't go again. So there's your 1 in there. Blessing. There's her missile, which she needs badly. And her armor. 6. Yep. So she's ready for combat again. Alright, his turn. He's got left, he's still got 3 in his hand. Okay. Well, 3 you can draw from. So let's get that cool out. So combat 11. He has no blessings. So 11s could be a little tough for him. And she has no blessing. Well, she has one blessing, she could help him. But that's not Well, this could, it would help. Add one die. Nah. Add two die to a combat strength. So that would really help him out a pretty good amount. Because you can use the Blessing of the Gods to mimic this one. So two die to a combat. So that'd be 3d8s he'd be using, plus 3. Instead of a normal 2d8. Well, take that back. 1, 2, 3, 4d8 he'd be rolling. 1, 2, 3, 4. Instead of a normal 3. Yeah, she'll go ahead and do it. This card, he's got 48 going against that ghoul. 1d8 for the crossbow, 1d8 for that, and she's mimicking this to add 2 dice to the combat strength, since she used a blessing. So, 48 to defeat and 11. 48 plus 3. Should have no problem here. That's 8 right there. Still got 3 more rolls. Can't lose. That'd be an 11. So that's gone. Now I've got to defeat a dexterity or stealth check, and his dex is an 8. No stealth. Roll an 8. Or 7. What was it? 6? It's a 6. Alright, so this location is closed. Now permanent closed. When you end your turn here, you may bury a card. Not worried about that. Alright, so we're on the final location. We know where the villain is. He has no place he can run to. And we're down to the final 8 turns. After this one. She can go after him if she really wants to. She's got cards to spare. Got 2 armors. Or she can just totally evade him. She has her magic. So she technically could beat him if he shows up. And he can discard one of these crossbows too to add another d4 to the check if she runs into him. So let's go ahead and get in there. Let her go. There he is! Alright, here we go. We can end this game right here. She has to recharge 2 cards. She will recharge invisibility. She will go ahead and recharge that crossbow as well. Keep the armors out in case she needs them. Alright, so she has to beat a 10. Here we go. Doing that. It's 1d12 plus 2 plus 2d4s. That plus that. Yep, and he will discard the crossbow to give her another d4. Well, proficient in weaponry. He is, make sure he is proficient in weapons. He is, okay. Had to double check it. Okay, so she's got 1d4 plus 3d4s. No blessings to help. But this should do it, you would think. So, plus 2. 3 of these. 2. 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. That tied it. And that killed him. So you still have 1 more 12 to roll, just to see. Plus a 2. So she got a 12. I only had to beat a 10, so that defeats him, and he is dead. So we've completed the first mission. Six cards left in her hand. She's still at 3, but she's got to draw at the end of this. That's the last thing I got to make sure. But she has more than enough cards. 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just had to draw back to her hand so she don't die. She has 3 cards left. Alright, so now we officially have 1. What did we miss out in there? There's that stupid specter again. Get rid of him. What is this thing? Zolgath. Nothing really special there. More holy water. There's the henchman. Another siren. Ghoul, and one acolyte ally. Alright, so that's that. Still had 8 rounds left. And this permanently closes since he's dead. And she had to discard a card, but that's fine. Okay, so we've completed this first mission. Brigandoom is defeated. Alright, so what is the reward? Each character draws a random item from the box. Hopefully it'll be something we can actually use. Alright. Let's make sure everything's put up before I draw. Villain gets out of the way. Alright. Each get random item. One item each. This is hearth item. Potion of healing. Look at that. That'll come in handy since we have no healing. And this is Sione's card. Cape of Escape. Bury this card to move or to evade an encounter and then move. You automatically succeed at a check required to move. That's a nice little item. So that's our rewards for this mission here. You got that. She got the cape. Alright, so that'll do it for this. I'm going to have to discard some cards here to get everybody's hand size back where it's supposed to be. See where we're keeping and what we're not going to keep. So I can get ready for the next mission. Because the hand size is 15, so he's got two cards he's got to get rid of. She's going to have a bunch to get rid of. She's got a lot of cards this round. Let's see how much she got to get rid of here. Yeah, she's got 21. So yeah, she's got six cards she's got to dump. Tis two, so got some loot there we could use. Definitely keeping that healing potion. And we didn't really pick up much else really worth keeping as far as I'm aware of. But anyway, that'll do it for this mission. Finally succeeded. We'll be back for another video when I complete start the next mission on this adventure, which should be the poison pill. And we'll see how that fares. But for now, that'll end this one. Nice to have a success. So the campaign can continue with these two characters, and we will see you back next time when we continue it on. So, hope you enjoyed it. Hope I didn't screw the rules up too much. And we, like I said, we'll see you back next video. See you then.